Now that you've thought about that, let me show you why this matters. Let me take the example of the middle line first. My arrows are going to look something like this. I'm sketching them in right now. It's just the distance from each point to sort of the predicted value for that point on the regression line. And if you were just summing the absolute value of the errors, you would just sum up all of these orange distances and you would have your answer. But now let's look at the top line. We could do the same thing here too. So now we start drawing in the distances. So while it would be closer to all of the points above it, it would be further away from all of the points below it. So taking these two points as concrete examples, it would be a little bit closer to the top point, a little bit farther away to the bottom point. But overall, the total error for these two example points would be exactly the same as the total error for these two points to the middle line. And in fact, the same thing would be true for the bottom regression line as well. And if you have equal number of points above and below each of these lines, then in general, that's always going to be true. There's a fundamental ambiguity when you use the absolute value of the errors in terms of exactly where the regression can fall. It could be anywhere in this range. In other words, there can be multiple lines that minimize the absolute errors, but there's only going to be one line that minimizes the error squared. In other words, this ambiguity does not exist when the metric that we use is not the absolute value of the distance, the absolute value of the distance squared. There's one more thing that I should add as well. This is a little bit more of a practical concern. And that is this: using the sum of the squared error as a way of finding the regression also makes the implementation underneath the hood of the regression much easier. It's much easier to find this line when what you're trying to do is minimize the sum of the squared errors instead of the sum of the absolute errors. And this is something that we have the luxury of not worrying about too much when we're using sklearn to do most of the computational heavy lifting for us. But of course, if you're actually writing the code that goes in and does the linear algebra to find the regression, or maybe the calculus to find the result of what your regression answer should be, then this is a big concern to you. This is another reason why traditionally regressions are going to be minimizing the sum of the squared error, is because the computationally it's just much easier to do that.